hype up SoCal Uncensored. He's got to decide which member of SCU will be staying out here tonight. Now there's a 2-on-2-on-2 triple threat Full Metal Mayhem match. The rest of his United States title time. Alpha, Chris Jericho, who is challenging Delson Hollow for his United States Championship here tonight. Of course, Hollow so far successfully defended against former U.S. champion KSJ and then put Shields at Merry Mayhem. Shields has an opportunity to win that briefcase later now when he goes head-to-head with the Executioner, Xander Mercer, who will walk out United States briefcase holder. But he is going to walk out United States briefcase, or United States champion right now. Can Chris Jericho knock off the outlaw Delson Hollow, the four-time champion, and pick up his first title here in UWA? Chris Jericho doesn't want to be the next MVP. He wants to be the next GMP abuser. No, I don't know. Maybe not, actually. Never mind. That was a bad example. He wants to be the next Randy Orton. Well, that's kind of still a bad example. Ghost Rider here tonight is the United States champion. He's looking to retain his U.S. championship here tonight on the biggest stage of the year, arguably, at Showdown in Sin City. Every pay-per-view has been equally great this year so far, but Showdown is going to be very important here for Delson Hollow, as I don't believe he has the best track record at Showdown. Remember back 2 years ago, that's where he defeated Vaquero to win the NXT Championship, the Summer Showdown. Here tonight, of course, Delson Hollow is going to look to retain the title instead of gain one. Can the outlaw Delson Hollow retain his United States Championship against one of the veterans here in the UWA, Chris Jericho? Look at those introductions here. U.S. title thrown up on the line is one of the best belts, design-wise, in my opinion.
Introducing the challenger from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, weighing in at 227 pounds, Chris Jericho! Introducing the champion from Richmond, Virginia, weighing in at 250 pounds, he is the Universal Wrestling Alliance United States Champion, the Outlaw L. Ken Howell.
To be fair, it doesn't sound like the crowd knows exactly who they're picking in this match, which I'm not surprised. I mean, given Hollow's recent actions that he's done to Nakamura and then KSJ, then Jericho's always been kind of a dickhead, especially back at Merry Mayhem. I mean, this is going to be very interesting to see who the crowd sides with. Luckily enough, we've switched to Chowie here for this match, as Mark needs a breather. And nonetheless, Chowie's going to ring the bell here. We're going to get this matchup underway. Delson Hollow with the go-behind on the challenger, Chris Jericho. Now the challenger, Chris Jericho, going to break the hold on the champ, Delson Hollow. Now he's going to take Hollow down to the canvas. Of course, Hollow, the one in the black trunks, Chris Jericho, or the black tights, rather, Chris Jericho in the blue trunks. Hollow now countered, go behind. For any new viewers here. Shot right to the face there from Delson Hollow. Now Jericho gonna send Hollow off the ropes. And nice hip toss there from Chris Jericho. Now Jericho gonna shoot a quick cover here. That's arrogance being shown here by Chris Jericho. Only a one count. That's very arrogant. Now Hollow gets right back up, shot to the ribs there. Now Hollow going for an early Hollow Valley Driver, and it connects. And went for that Hollow Valley Driver quick there to Delson Hollow. Now going for a quick cover here, only a one count for Delson Hollow as well. Now Jericho right back up to his feet. Now Chris Jericho butterflies the arms, and a butterfly backbreaker from Chris Jericho. Oh God, and the challenger now looking to go big as well. Lion Salt! Really Lion Salt now from Chris Jericho. Jericho might be calling for the end now here as he's setting him up. Jericho's lifting him up. And Hollow able to counter though. Delson Hollow able to counter. Maybe he's trying to send him off the ropes, get that added momentum for the code breaker. Now Hollow up on the top rope here. He's waiting for Jericho. Oh man, he measured him up. And he just caught him there with that diving DDT. That's definitely worth a cover if you're Delson Hollow. Only a one count though. Jericho kicks out a one. I don't know how. That was a devastating DDT. Like, holy crap. And now Jericho going to send Hollow right back into the ring. I don't know how the hell Jericho recovered so quick after that diving DDT from the Outlaw. Now Hollow kicks up off of the forearm and now going in for another cover. And Hollow is not messing around right now. He wants to end this quickly. That's respect to Jericho if that's what I would say it is. And now Hollow caught the leg and Hollow exploded into the ropes and Jericho's knees just bounced off those ropes. I think that's gonna come back to haunt Jericho later. Hollow just banged up those knees of Jericho. Now code breaker from Chris Jericho. Jericho pulls a code breaker out of nowhere. 1, 2, and Hollow kicks out. I'm telling you, man, those knees and legs are damaged of Chris Jericho now, and that's going to hurt the effectiveness of the code breaker. I don't know if Hollow planned to do that or not, but that was clever. Now Jericho trying to rally back here, a couple shoulder tackles, and Jericho somehow lands on his feet even with the bad legs. And now up to the top, axe handle. See Jericho kind of wincing in pain there. His legs are damaged. Chris gonna try to get off his feet here, going for a bow and arrow submission hold here on Delson Hollow, trying to wear him down. It's Jericho, and now Jericho, Hollow went for a cover there, countered out and into a pinfall. Jericho kicks out immediately. Now Chris Jericho in control, let's go of Hollow. Might have been a mistake, or maybe not. Michinoku driver. Right in for the cover here is Chris Jericho, 2 and a 2 count. He's less than a second away from winning the title there. Now Jericho disrespect to Hollow again. Went for the right hand, Delson Hollow counters. Now Hollow gets back into the ring here. Jericho caught the legs, sweeps the legs. Oh God, he's looking for it. He's gonna roll him over. The walls of Jericho. The walls of Jericho is locked in on Delson Hollow. He's got him in the walls. Is Hollow going to be forced to tap? He picks the ankle there. It's Delson Hollow. Now Jericho going right back after it. Trying to go for the walls again. But Hollow kicks him off. Kicking his stomach there from Jericho. Right into a code breaker. Code breaker times 2 there from Chris. 1, 2, new U.S. champ. No! Hollow kicks out. Tell you, man, how injured are those legs of Chris Jericho right now after going off those ropes early on? Hollow's just been able to kick out 2 code breakers, and now Jericho's going back in for another submission, trying to pull apart the arm of Delson Hollow. And now Hollow fighting out the cross arm breaker as well. See, Jericho's almost like a wounded animal, man. He's just trying to go for the kill right now. Hollow caught him with a Hollow point. Now Jericho in trouble here. He's on the defensive. Hollow now locking a rally in with some forearms and now a sling blade. From the Outlaw, Hollow lifts him up. Now Delson, right into the Sleepy Hollow. Sleepy Hollow's locked in on Chris Jericho. Jericho is locked in the Sleepy Hollow. Now Hollow's trying to make Jericho tap out here, trying to return the favor. Jericho's not budging though. Fred Hollow's just gonna try to finish him now. Right hand to the face, one in the chamber. Oh wait, Jericho rolls out of it. Rolls out of the one in the chamber, right into a third code breaker. A third code breaker from Chris. One, two. What the hell is it going to take to put away Hollow? Hollow just kicked out of a third code breaker. That damn Jericho is going for another quick cover here. Two on two count again, but once again, Hollow kicks out. Like I said, Jericho's knees are badly injured, man. He's not getting, he's probably not even getting a quarter of the damage that code breaker normally does. He needs to come up with a different move trying to take out Hollow. Now Hollow's just stomping the shit out of the chest of Chris Jericho. Jesus, Hollow right now knows he's in control, man. He's just taunting Jericho. And now, night-night, swinging neck breaker there from Delson Hollow. Jericho right back up to his feet. Hollow counter whips him into the corner, though. Now what is Hollow playing here? Jericho counterwhips. Hollow slides out from under the ring. Ropes, holy crap, and Hollow catches him with a clothesline. Right in for the cover here, one. And Jericho not giving in here to Hollow at all. Hollow looks freaking pissed. Now what the, he's lifting up Jericho here. No, oh, come on, that was a low blow. Blatant low blow right in the face there. Of the ref, and now Hollow calling up Jericho. Oh God, here's a one in the chamber. Gotta be kidding me. Look at that low, he's pretty much got a one at this point. He just low blow Jericho, and now he's gonna do two one in the chambers in a row. Jesus, the hooks the injured leg, and that's it. Just like that, Delson Hollow retains his United States Championship. Yeah. Goddamn, 2-1 in the chambers in a row there. And yeah, Jericho's not getting out of that. Hollow survived 3 code breakers in the night and the walls of Jericho. 2-1 in the chambers is what it took for Hollow to put away Chris Jericho. God damn. Southern Native had a great win last year in his home city of Chicago, Illinois, before Seth Rollins fucked him over. And that's freaking, there's like a freaking attitude adjustment off the top of the ladder through a damn table. And since then, Rollins and Jeff have had a bad history with one another this year. The best feud of the year, in my opinion. Jeff and Rollins beat the crap out of each other. And it all concluded back at Uprising. And Jerry Jets will knock off Seth Rollins to win this opportunity to face Delson Hollow for the United States Championship. Jerry Jets with a huge task ahead of him here tonight. Dead end. Will it be Delson Hollow's dead end for his United States title reign? Or will it be the last shot here for Jerry Jets? At winning the title, it's been forever since Jets has held gold. And the UWA, and the last two runs that he had were not that great. Jerry Jets loved nothing more than to get this opportunity even not to win the United States title, become the third ever United States champion in UWA history. Put his name through with KSJ and this man right here, the Outlaw. course, he is your current reigning defending United States champion. He is the Ghost Rider. He is the Outlaw, Dolson Hollow. He is a former two-time Pure Mayhem champion, one-time NXT champion, and of course the United States champion. Hollow, of course, won Survivor at Revival, back at Revival to kick off 2019. And a win that was for the Outlaw, Dolson Hollow, knocking off KSJ. Hollow needs to keep that momentum going. But that's going to be easier said than done as he faces Jerry Jett, Hyperspeed Jerry Jett. It's going to be a very tough task from both these competitors tonight. It's going to be a very even matchup. Getting into the introduction here. First time imagining that.
United States champion, the Outlaw L.N. Howell.
Hollow raises the belt high above his head. This matchup is about to be underway. Dolson Hollow, Jerry Jett's United States championship on the line. The Japanese ref raising the United States title. It's perfect. And Chowdhury rings the bell. This matchup is underway here. These two gonna walk up. Hollow gonna back Jerry Jett up into the corner here. Dolson Hollow in control right now on the challenger, Jerry Jett. Gonna get a clean break here between the two. Lock up again. Hollow backs Jets up against the ropes. And Jets with a cheap shot there to Hollow. And Jets means business here tonight. Hollow is underestimating Jets. He's not anymore. Oh, God. No, jeez. And Jets right now using his speed there. Oh, look, the baby taking into hyperspeed here. Possibly. Jets connects with a moonsault right there on the Dolson Hollow. Nice leg sweep right into the moonsault. Now Jerry Jets lifts Hollow up here. What? Oh, he is not. A buckle bomb! Shades of Seth freaking Rollins. Jerry Jets showing a bit of tribute there to Rollins. Surprisingly went for the stomp. Hollow moved out of the way. Shot right in the leg. Gonna take out the speed of Jerry Jets. Nice planning there from Hollow. Hollow now full speed ahead. Jets caught him with the knees and the spine. And now, oh my God, what a dragon twist cutter from Jerry Jets. What a nice combination. Now the two lock up again here. Jets takes Hollow down off his feet to the canvas. And he's going to lock up a bit some more here. Nice clean break, and he caught him with the corkscrew calf kick. Jets right now is using his speed advantage on Dolson Hollow, and he's doing it well. But Hollow cuts him off there, sliding near the ribs. Now Hollow looking for something there. Doesn't matter, Jets counters. Nice. Now Jets just driving in left to the face of Dolson Hollow. Hollow underestimating Jerry Jets at all. He's paying for it right now. Jumping DDT. Satellite DDT from Jerry Jets. Now Jets. They send Hollow. There goes Chowdhury. And no, Hollow moved out of the way. Going up for his sake. Jets counter. Shuffle the midsection. Kick to the stomach. Now Jets off the ropes. He's going to look for that faith breaker. And it connects, sets him right up. Jets now at the top. Jerry Jets looking to drop that elbow. Shades of Rollins from Uprising as well. And set out Uranage from Hollow, and that'll turn the tides a bit here in the favor of the champ. Now Hollow is going to look to wear out Jets. Oh, Jets kicks right back up to his feet. Jets is having none of that. Tilt the world for a Corona. Holy crap, man. Jets is just continuing to use his speed over Delson Hollow. Stiff kick in the back there. Hollow sends him into the corner. Knees to the spine yet again. Jets now connects with a drop kick in the back. And Jerry Jets gets countered by Hollow. Kick to the stomach. Oh, and a face breaker again. Send him up again. Jets is going in for the kill here. There's him that handspring Pele. And it connects right across the eye of Delson Hollow. That is not enough. I don't think that did much damage to the champ. Not like it's Rollins who has eye issues. And now Jets. Jets able to count in the Hollow Valley. Terry Jets counts the Hollow Valley. Driver near the face. Bust Delson Hollow open. Hollow is bleeding. Huge kick. Lands again on the same target as the last knee. Cover one, two, and a two count kick out there by Hollow. Jets now going to work on the arm of Delson Hollow. Jets in control here. Hollow cut the leg, knee in the face. Now, oh, guys caught him. Hollow point DDT. Beautifully done there by the champ Delson Hollow. That was a knee right into the Hollow point. And now Hollow, this is vintage Delson Hollow here with that sling blade. Hollow back in this, went for the Sleepy Hollow. Jerry Jets scouts it. Now, there's Hollow who scouts Jets. Two going back in there, what a clothesline. Jets rolls up, oh no. We know what Hollow does from there. Jets needs to get back in the ring. Jets scouts it. Jumps over the ropes, back into the ring. Caught the leg again, then Hollow. Exploder suplex into the ropes. See him use that on Chris Jericho, and that's what led to the demise of Chris Jericho in that title match. A showdown in Sin City, and oh no. This is what he did to Kenny Omega that led to his demise. And no! Throw first into the ropes. That is cheap by Delson Hollow, but you gotta do whatever it takes to win the match, right? I rake, and now he's clotheslines him onto the floor. Hollow just took multiple cheap shots in a row. Slingshot him first onto the ropes all the way across the ring and raked his eyes. Jets right now is stunned, man. Hollow now fights off Jets, kick to the stomach. Jets now counters yet again, leg sweep. Right into the moonsault again. And he's hurting right now. Jets needs to be careful here. Sends Hollow back into the ring. He's in control. But he's got to remain in control here. Jets to the top. He's thinking, oh, fuck! And once again, pulling out another move from Seth Rollins. Jerry Jets. Now Jets, Falcon's arrow. Falcon's arrow. Kip off from Jets. Jets is rolling, man. Jerry Jets is rolling here. Jets, Black Rain Driver. This is what he used to put away Seth, but Hollow. Hollow fights the Black Rain Driver. Hollow, oh no, oh no. No, right into one in the chamber. Cover, one, two, and Hollow just steals the freaking victory. Delson Hollow retains the United States Championship in a hard-fought victory. We're not going to need replays here. Oh no, we see him do this going mega after the match. Come on. Hollow, fuck you, you piece of shit. Fuck off, Hollow. Chowie, stop him. Get him off of him, man. This is ridiculous. Jesus, enough is enough. Oh, come on. No, Hollow's got a chair. Come on, man. Don't do this, Hollow, you piece of shit. You suck. Yeah! Dean Rollins! Seth freaking Rollins! Rollins coming to the aid of Jerry Jets here! I can't believe what you see. And it looks like Dolphin Hall is making his way down to the ring here. God, I hope Hall will somehow can survive this match. He just really about to even say, but I can't imagine that. Hall is going to need some serious help here going up against the undefeated Aleister Black. Hall has survived Road Warriors to get to hear the main event of Showdown. Now you have to come on after what that despicable act just happened. God, I hope Paulo breaks Alistair's face. Undefeated psycho bastard. Frazier's champion, the Dutch Destroyer, the anti-hero, Undertaker's favorite demon, Aleister Black. They say Aleister Black has been undefeated all year. No one's been able to even get close to beating Aleister Black, in my opinion. Basically uncharted pit. This is uncharted waters for Dolphin Hall to be in, that's for sure. So Hall is gonna have to make like Nathan Drake, or he's not gonna stand a chance. Crazy freaking night. I don't even know what to say right now. Universe title thrown up on the line here. Of course, this is a regular match for the Universe title. That, of course, means DQ is all a thing.
From Richmond, one ball. Virginia. Weighing in at 250 pounds.
Paulo's gonna have to channel his inner Hellboy if he wants to win this one.
Introducing the champion from Amsterdam, Holland, weighing in at 215 pounds. He is the Universal Wrestling Alliance Universal Champion, Aleister Black.
This is your main event of probably one of the most wildest freaking shows ever in UWA history. This is a nuts. You've got the undefeated Aleister Black versus the Outlaw, UWA's resident ghost rider, Dolphin Hollow. Here we go. And the bell is rung. Hollow walking right up there. He's not scared of Black. Black throws the first shot. Throws a kick, shoving Hollow off, and Hollow counters, catches him on the ropes. Hollow's got to be careful. Aleister obviously has the strike advantage, and Hollow pops him up. Holy crap, the power pop of German. Bridge, one. Then one count. Aleister kicks out at one. Hollow into stomping. Aleister, moonsault. beautiful move there from Aleister Black, able to catch a deadlift German of his own. Heindel bridge German, I should say, rather. Now there comes the strikes. Holler needs to be careful here. Now off the ropes here, looking for that sliding STO. First STO, rather. Now he lifts him up here, looking to follow up. But once again, Aleister caught him with the strikes. Black's just too damn quick, man. Hollow able to move out of the way there. Counter whip. Hollow slides under the ropes. Black, no. Oh, God. Hollow running right after him. And no, it's not going to happen, man. Oh, now Hollow counters Black. These two just going back and forth. Hollow, leg sweep, figure four. He can't, woo! He can't do the freaking Black Mass if his legs are injured. To break his damn legs. Of course, you don't see the Undertaker out here at ringside. He's been losing more and more power as of, oh my God! That super kick just took Hollow's face off. Now a double boot stomp. That was the most brutal super kick I think I've ever seen. Aleister Black now trying to rip the arm out of socket of Delson Hollow. Cover from the Dutch Destroyer. Not even a one count. Ballsy by Hollow to kick out that quick. And now Hollow looking for that freaking, a quick draw, but it's not going to work. Now kick to the stomach. Near the stomach, rather. Now Aleister is continuing with those strikes, picking apart Delson Hollow. Alistair's got a strike advantage, he's got a ruthless aggression advantage, and he's got a freaking speed advantage, so Hollow's really got to be careful. He's got to play defensive in this entire match. Shot to the midsection. Because Hollow can knock, Aleister can knock out Hollow before Hollow can knock out Aleister. Aleister springboards back into the ring here, but Hollow, Hollow's caught him. Hollow Valley Driver. Nicely done there by Hollow. Moved out of the way. Snap DDT. Bust Hollow open. Oh, no. Black could be looking in this one early here. Oh, God. That knees will took out Page. Cover here. One, two, Black. No. Oh, God. It's over at this point. Aleister lifting him up by his foot there. And now, wait, no, just opts to go for a tombstone here. No, oh, that one's for Undertaker, obviously. Now Black going to the outside. Oh, no, if he uses a chair, he's going to win this via disqualification. And Mark's not about to let that happen. Mark takes the chair from Aleister Black. It's a risky move considering he already got the shit knocked out by Colt Shields earlier. Hollow rolled out of the way. Kids gonna get, oh my God! Oh my, full of greatness! One, two, what? Kick out from Black! Hollow just hit the fall of greatness on Aleister Black! It's right out of the playbook of Nick Richards! What the hell? The hell did we just, now Hollow's going after the chair! Hollow's about to lose his cool here. Now Mark doing the right thing, taking the chair from Hollow as well. He just pulled out the fall of greatness, his bitter enemy's move, and that didn't even do the job for him. Double chicken wing, gut buster. Freaking fall of greatness from Hollow. Now Hollow, forearm, a couple forearms, and a sling blade. Hellboy's trying to rally back into this here. Hollow Valley, but Aleister lands on his feet. Shot to the midsection. He's caught Hollow. Boot right to the head. Boot right to the head, you're fucking dead, man. Black lifts him up, and here we go. He's gonna chop him down. No! Oh, damn! Cover. One, two, does Black have it, Aleister? No! And Alistair now starting to show some frustration here. I don't think Alistair can believe Hollow got that close to beating him with that fall of greatness. Hollow needs to pull out something big again here. I think that might have been the only trick he had up his sleeve. Now a single leg Boston Crab locked in by Alistair Black. Hollow shoves him off. Hollow, I'm not sure what he was going for there. Alistair counters European uppercut. Black. Alistair sends him into the corner. Full speed ahead. Hollow moves. Snapmare takedown. Soccer ball kick right to the spine. Oh no. No, and another knee right to the head. Jesus, man. Alistair is not he is not playing around, man. One, two. And a kick out. Alistair is going to chop him down again here. God damn, Hollow. Dude, he could not take much more punishment at all, man, at this point. Jesus. Now stomped right to the ribs. Alistair Black in full control, man. It's Black Mass. Black Mass connects. Damn. What? He kicked out. Oh no, now Alistair's going for another one here. Black Ribs at Alistair's compound. Black Grave was at that dungeon as you always see Alistair in. Down the basement of that house. Oh God, I bet the Undertaker's in there. The hell is Black Grave doing? The hell is Leon doing? God, he just stabbed his father. Black Grave just stabbed the Undertaker. Leon just killed the Undertaker. Black Grave. Oh, Alistair Black is pissed. But you know what that means? He's lost his power. He ducks it. Wait, follow. Oh, KO. Right out of Randy Orton's playbook into the Sleepy Hollow. Sleepy Hollow and Alistair taps. Alistair Black just tapped out. Black Grave just killed the Undertaker. James Mitchell just told Black Grave to kill his father. That took away Alistair Black's energy. Undertaker lost possession over him. They gave Hall the opening. He just won it with Randy Orton, another one of his bitter rivals' moves. What the fuck did we just see? Dude, AJ Styles, one of the best wrestlers ever, to be honest. And now out comes Bruce Payne. He's not wasting any time. He's showing the wounds, the battle scars from round one and two. His bruise, he's bandaged up here.
Oh, Bruce New Engine, fair enough. Bruce in here.
Okay, hold on, wait, what? But are you serious right now? Okay. Due to the freaking crazy shit that's happening tonight, the freaking announcer forgot to announce the whole fucking thing. And no DQ, yeah, no disqualifications, obviously, because the match is falls count anywhere. Not only is it falls count anywhere, but it's freaking 2 out of 3 falls. Here, closing the show tonight with Bruce Payne and Dawson Hollow in a falls count anywhere, no disqualification, 2 out of 3 falls match. What the fuck? Go big or go home, I guess. Hollow now taped up freaking ribs. Drew Payne obviously with a taped up shoulder due to taking that gator roll on top of the steel chair and shoulder first. Paula, of course, got the taped-up ribs after going through the freaking table roughly with that goddamn powerbomb. Also getting freaking body slammed back first onto the damn ladder. Not even just the ladder, the legs of the freaking ladder. I think there's gonna be a more brutal thing for it to happen to Harlow than that. And he got freaking body slammed, freaking back first, lower back, spine, the rib area onto the damn ladder. I just want to point out that Harlow now is getting payback for what he did to Gargano earlier, though, damaging the freaking ribs of Gargano. Now it's Harlow with the banged up ribs going into this match, into the finals of the Ring Warriors tournament here. Chowie rings the bell, Drew Payne and Delson Hollow. Hollow going for the gravy train quick here. Connects with it right away. That's the move he used to beat Fatal last round. Get it off the top of the damn ladder though. Now Hollow went for a forearm. Drew Payne ducks. Hollow falls to his freaking feet there. It falls off his feet rather. We can barely stand right now. Nice counter there to Drew Payne. Tripping him up. The hell is... Oh God, belt, no, and Hollow going right after the injured shoulder and upper back there with that neck breaker in the ropes. Can't say I blame Hollow. Of course, we don't have very many weapons. Hollow pulling out the damn baseball bat. Drew Payne telling him to bring it. Payne moved out of the way, caught Hollow with a forearm. Now Brute is going to power Hollow into the corner, right out into a tombstone pile driver, but Hollow counters. Hollow counters into a tombstone of his own. Brute was trying to send a message to Aleister Black there, but instead it was Hollow who sent the message. And off the ropes, Hollow looking for that rib breaker, but it doesn't matter because Brute Payne counters with a backbreaker right up to those ribs. And now Brute biting the fingers of Delson Hollow. Anything it takes to win this right now, they're going to have to beat their opponent twice to win this damn match. And now Brute, right to the ribs there. Jesus, you know these two are going to attack the other person's injured body part here. And Brute kind of looks Hollow back into the... Oh, come on, ref. Chowie, he just raked the freaking eyes of Hollow. So cheap, but of course it's effective. And it's legal to know this qualification match, obviously. Hollow now trying to fight Brute Payne off here. God, this match started out very fast paced, but you can tell they're winded. Oh no, Hollow continuing to get punched in the ribs there. Brute knows exactly what to go after to win this. And now Brute Payne's got him up. Tombstone pile driver. This time the message was sent and delivered. Went to follow up Hollow counters. Oh God, now right after the arm. Hollow has got to protect those ribs. Brute Payne's got to protect that shoulder. Now Hollow shoves him off and clotheslines him into the corner here. Went to follow up, Brute Payne moved out of the way. Northern Lariat! And Hollow did not want to allow that to happen. He does not want to get hit with any of those Northern Lariats, man. That could have been it, but Hollow kicks out of two. Brute now showing a bit of frustration there. Couldn't lift his left arm. He might have dislocated it there for a second. Now Brute Payne sends Hollow out to the floor here. Brute now going to look to take the fight to Hollow out on the outside. Oh God, this is going to hurt a lot more than inside the ring. He's going for the pendulum of Payne out on the floor, and it connects on the floor. You see Hollow grabbing at his ribs. Cover from Brute. That could be fall number one. And no, Hollow kicks out of two. Even if it was, the match wouldn't be over yet because Brute would have to beat him twice. Whether that be via pinfall or submission. Now Brute has Hollow by the back of the head here. Once again, Hollow able to fight off Brute Payne. But I wonder who's in worse condition right now. Set out Impaler DDT on the floor. Nice move there from Hollow. And yeah, I noticed that Brute was trying to pop his shoulder back into place. It might be a little dislocated. I think he freaking got it though. Nonetheless, Hollow might re-dislocate it here at this point. Just throwing Brute Pain around, man. He hit the freaking floor hard there off that Impaler DDT. Now this is getting hard to watch, man. As Hollow's just throwing around Brute Pain. Oh, no. Hollow now's making his way backstage here, and it looks like Brute Pain's following him in there backstage. Brute Pain and Delson Hollow are backstage in the back here. This fight has moved to the back. Remember, his falls count anywhere. Hollow goading him in back there. Now an exploder suplex through the damn table. Hollow just suplexed Brute Pain through a freaking table. Now they're... He didn't have any... Oh, no. And now Brute once again back to those injured ribs. And another Northern Lariat. Brute right now in control. Hollow counters knee in the face. And a flying forearm. Hollow somehow with a kip up. Man, I would not be doing that, man, right now. That's got to damage his injured ribs even more. Now... Oh God, Brute yet again going back to the ribs. It's been the game plan. That's been the strategy this whole match. Now he just bitch slapped Hollow. And a third Northern Lariat here in this match to Delson Hollow. Hollow just got cracked with another Northern Lariat. And Hollow right now is hurt, man. He's loopy. He doesn't even know where he's at. Brute Pain now drives him on his neck. And Hollow right now has some serious head damage. Brute sent him right into the freaking dumpster there. Nice backbreaker. Oh no. Oh no, elevated flatliner, and that just took them both out. Brute Pain's too tired to capitalize. Oh, there we go. Now he falls into the cover. Chowie has made his way backstage here. 1-2, and Hollow kicks out a 2 off the elevated flatliner. No, no, Brute's going to finish here. Tornado headbutt. Hollow moves out of the way. Brute Pain landing hard on the floor. Now Hollow. Hollow Valley Driver on the concrete. I don't know if that was on purpose, but that was right on the strip of concrete instead of the carpet. And now I'm freaking running the chamber onto the steel chair. God damn, man, that's got to do it here. First fall to Hollow. Brute still fucking kicked out. Dude, Aleister Black is loving this at this point, man. Two are killing each other to face Aleister. They just have a month to recuperate. I'm Brute Pain. I do not get up right now because Hollow's wheeling the trash can. He's about to take out the trash can right to the head of Brute Pain. Any one of these shots can easily bust Brute open, man. You. Including that. Jesus, man. Hollow now is trying to drag the limp body of Brute Pain. I don't even think he can move him. Say he's going to lift him up here. That might be easier. Brute's got a bit of a weight advantage on Delson Hollow. Now Hollow lifting up Brute. He's going to... Oh, Jesus. Threw him into the cement wall. Jesus Christ, he's rearranging Brute Pain's face right now. Now into the locker room. Better be careful. Last time Ice-T was in there, we lost a security guard. Fucking enough for them, it's empty. And now another Hollow Valley Driver. It's time in the freaking locker room. Cover here. Chowie out of position in the doorway here. 1-2. Somehow in hell, Brute Pain kicks out of another Hollow Valley Driver. You have got to be kidding me. Now Hollow's... Oh no, this... Oh God! Oh no! Oh! He just super kicked Brute Pain's head into the freaking locker. Now come on, Chowie, get over there. 1-2. And there goes the first freaking fall there for Delson Hollow. Hollow super kicked Brute. Oh no, he's gonna do it again. Oh, jeez, head first off the locker again. Goes Blue Payne. And Holo, there's no way Blue Payne is not in a freaking concussion right now. And Blue can't even follow up. Damn, this is freaking brutal. From Blue gets for freaking attacking the ribs of Holo the whole match. Look at cheap shots and now right into the freaking locker. She's in Holo right now. It's continuing to throw Brute around like a rag doll. I wonder if Brute was playing possum in Worlds of War. Maybe he's playing possum right now. Oh, I think, and that's what exactly what it was. Is Brute Payne counters there, connects with a wicked forearm. Then he just flatlined Holo with that forearm. Brute continuing to toss him up the backstage area here. Blue Payne is looking to follow up. Oh no, come on, not another table. Come on, Blue, we don't need to lose another freaking table. We're definitely gonna have to start a GoFundMe for freaking tables. Oh God, now Blue Payne, come on, man. Oh my God! Freaking Regal Plex head first through the damn table. And now a Northern Lariat to the back of the neck. Jesus Christ, and somehow Hollow's still fighting him off. This is ridiculous, man. This is just straight up ridiculous. Now as Hollow lifts up Blue Payne, and now trying to recover. Here's Hollow in a last ride to Blue Payne. Now wait, what? Hollow going back out to the arena here. Now Blue Payne's falling on 360 tornado headbutt on the stage. Cover. Where's Chowie? 1, 2, and Holo kicks out at 2. Now Brute right now is down by one fall. Can make our way back to the ring here, or at least to the stage. Brute get caught with a right there. Now one in the chamber from Holo. Right back to the ribs, right into the tornado headbutt. That's genius. Right there from Brute Payne. Cover. 1, 2. And he has tied things up. Jesus, and now right back to the ribs with that kick right to the spine. Now Brute sending Holo back down to the ring here. It's like that, the German freaking, a German juggernaut here. Start calling him that, that's kind of catchy. Unless this douchebag, that works too. Brute Payne sending Holo back to the ring, although I'm not too fond of either of these two, to be honest. Now Brute sends Holo back into the ring here. Brute Payne. And he's found that sledgehammer from earlier. You guys went right after the ribs of Holo with it. Oh God, Holo luckily just barely caught that in time. And right hand to the face, one in the chamber. But yet again, Brute back to the ribs. And again, a second time right into the 360 headbutt. Oh my God, Holo's right back up to his feet. He just no-sold that shit. Brute's gone in the corner. He doesn't even know what to do right now. Brute just stalling there. Holo counters. Brute Payne with an elbow to the face. Now a forearm right to the face yet again. I don't even know who's more damaged right now. Who the hell is going to move on to challenge Aleister Black at Showdown in San Francisco for the Universe Championship? Now Brute. He's used this all night so far. That trifecta of clotheslines, shades of the King of Hardcore. Now Brute's dragging him out to the center of the ring here. Brute. Oh God, just stomping on the ribs there. That is freaking disgusting. Oh, come on, you freaking scumbag. Now just pulling back on the fingers of Holo. You're trying to snap the... Oh God, now double knees right to the ribs yet again. Brute just continuing after those ribs. Went for the Northern Lariat. Holo ducked and now delivering right to the face of Brute Payne. This is freaking brutal, man. Now nice counter there from Brute. To get Holo right back to grabbing those ribs, man. Clothesline counter. Holo picked apart the injured shoulder there finally again. And now just stomping on the hand. And here we go. This will attack the shoulder. The swinging neck breaker. Night night goes Blue Pain. Hollow now. Oh, blocking, and these two just squaring off there right in the center of the ring. Test of strength. Hollow went for a Northern Lariat of his own. Brute Pain caught him, and now Brute with another Northern Lariat right in for the cover here. One, two, and Hollow kicks out a two. And now Brute, no! I don't think Hollow realized it, but that was the wrong shoulder. Now Hollow to the top. Here, the heat-seeking elbow right to the injured shoulder. That time he connected on the right one. Heat-seeking elbow from Hollow. Right away counters right away again. Hollow's grabbing at the ribs. 360 headbutt tornado style again. Cover here from Brute Pain. One, two. That was a freaking fast count there from Chowie. I had hoped that was on accident. Jesus. Hollow's still able to kick out two, even the top of a freaking fast count. Chopping now. Hollow chopping the injured chest and shoulder. Brute overpowers Hollow. Shot to the midsection. This is getting down to the wire. You can tell, man, it was almost over there. Once again, you see Brute just go right back to a cheap shot from the ribs. Oh, God, now Pain stomping on the back of the neck. Continuing to add up that damage that he was doing with the Northern Lariat. Now Hollow looking for the submission. He's used on Jerry Jets multiple times. No way. He's going to get Brute Pain up there for it now. Oh God, I can't imagine he'll be able to hold this long. He's going to make Brute tap quick, and yeah, that's exactly what I figured. Brute Pain is able to get out of it. Hollow with those injured ribs, he wasn't going to be able to hold enough air in to be able to keep that in. He's going to lose oxygen too quick. Now one in the chamber, one in the chamber, but yet again, Brute Pain back to those injured ribs. Now Hollow's laying them right to the face of Brute, and he's busted Brute Pain open. Brute Pain is now bleeding. One, two, and oh, that was almost it. One thing that kept Brute in, I would say, is Hollow pinned down the bad shoulder. Should have pinned down the good one, made him kick out with the bad shoulder. It's bad positioning there for Hollow. Uh-oh, come on, don't do this, God, he just spiked him on the apron. That freaking DDT, and Brute was rolling all over the place on the floor there. He just got spiked on his goddamn head on the apron. Now Hollow with a right just decked Brute, and he can't even stand right now. Now Hollow just taking him down, just delivering rights and lefts into the face. Brute can't even defend himself right now. Damn, look at the amount of blood that's accumulated on the face of Brute Pain. Hollow has been, Hollow has become very sadistic. And now right to the injured shoulder with a sledgehammer goes Delson Hollow. Just pounding that hammer into the freaking shoulder. That, no! He just slammed that shoulder right into the freaking hammer. Dude, there's no question about it at this point. His shoulder is freaking dislocated. Dawson Hollow has dislocated the shoulder of Brute Pain. And now I think he just made Pain pass out. Now he's about to put him away with a one in the chamber here. There's no way. Brute's setting off right now, and again back to the ribs. Those injured ribs of Hollow right now really screwing him here. Pendulum of Pain. And that's it. Brute's got to cover him here. Brute's got this one. Brute is moving on to showdown San Francisco, but no, somehow in holy hell, Delson Hollow just kicked out with a second Pendulum of Pain. Gotta think Brute didn't get all of it since his shoulder's dislocated right now. Now Hollow's caught him yet again, and he finally connects with the one in the chamber. That'll do it. Now Delson Hollow is going to showdown in San Francisco. Now Brute Pain kicks out again. I don't even fucking know anymore. Jesus Christ. Amount of blood Brute's lost right now. Now Hollow's going to try to roll him up. Going to try to take the cheap way out, man. And Brute still kicks out at two. How much respect Hollow has for Brute right now, man. He's trying everything he can to put him away. Northern Lariat, Hollow scouts at this time. That would have been it. blown in the face, shot right to the shoulder there. Oh no, that's going to be shoulder first into the canvas yet again. You see Brute grabbing at that freaking dislocated shoulder, and Hollow's just continuing to stomp on it, and he's trying to rip freaking Brute's arm off. She's going to rip it clean off. Now Hollow Valley Driver. Damn, he might have to rip the arm clean off if he wants to win this, to be frankly honest. Bruce somehow is continuing to fight back here with a dislocated shoulder. And now, oh God, you see him there, he used his other arm. Even the fact that one's dislocated, Hollow kicked out before Chowie can even get out there to count the fall. Jesus Christ, Hollow shoves him off. Bruce right now is in a bad way, elevated flatliner. Somehow able to get him up there with one freaking arm. We might want to attempt to pop that shoulder back into place right now. Oh no, he's going to try to even the odds here. Oh God, he just attempted to dislocate the arm of Hollow now. They've both got dislocated arms. You would dig him a Hollow right back to the freaking shoulder. Hollow is not laying up on that dislocated shoulder. And now another one in the chamber. One in the chamber. Stacked him up in the corner. That's got to be it, man. One, two. Hollow is moving on. Are these two even fucking human? Jesus Christ, and Hollow is just continuing to toss stomp on that shoulder. Oh, no. Oh, no. Dude, Brute just landed headfirst on the hammer, man. Northern Lariat there from Brute Payne. Dude, Chowie, I might have to fucking call this one again. We might have to do a ref. Can't do a stoppage for the freaking Rain Warriors finals. Might have to fucking call this, though. Brute Pendulum of Payne. Wait, wait, Hollow. Hollow scouts it. Brute couldn't keep him up with that dislocated shoulder. Hollow was able to scout it. And now he's going in for the kill here. One in the chamber. Ring shattering. One in the chamber here. One, two, and then Hollow moves on the showdown. Jesus Christ, man. Get the damn medic out here. Get the damn medic out here right now. Chowie, get the fucking medic out here. I don't care if you can't speak English, you stupid fuck. Get the fucking medic out here. Jesus. Man, Brute is fucked up right now. Seems to be set for Hollow. Hollow's got out of the concussion. Brute Payne has to have a freaking dislocated shoulder. There's no way around that. Brute Payne had a freaking... Jesus Christ, man. KSJ and Hollow, what do you think? This has got to be a five-star match.
It's certainly going to be. I mean, one's been, you know, as you said, a former United champion. The other one has been an NXT champion, a Pure Mayhem champion.
Two-time Pure Mayhem champion.
Just counting like
heads
the whole
yeah.
He's been there.
Yeah, I mean, now he's a four-time champion in UWA, so I mean, the way Hollow won was really cheap, and I wasn't happy about it at all. He kind of screwed over Nakamura, but nonetheless, I mean, all the shit that Nakamura did to him, but then, like, he just went full douchebag back in Revival. You can definitely tell by the crowd. The crowd was not happy at all. He freaking punched Hollow in the dick after Hollow eliminated two people. Like, it was really pathetic on the part of Hollow. I mean, like, the crowd has quickly turned on Hollow, even though his grandpa's probably still in the hospital. Anything to add to that?
I mean, after all the shit Nakamura did to Hollow, I'm gonna say he kind of deserved it, but at the same time,
I thought it was over at WrestleVerse. I mean, Hollow got his retribution there. I mean, he didn't have to do Nakamura like that. He ended up just setting the gauntlet. He was the last man in the gauntlet. Nakamura already had to go through the machine, Brian Cage, and Adam Fowler to get to that point. Nakamura was spent. Hollow freaking punched him in the dick within the first 2 minutes of the match. And then ended up winning later on, but because of that cheap shot. So, I mean, it was really scummy of Hollow, but nonetheless, he is now the United States champion. And I know from the fact, from the amount of conversations I've had with KSJ, he does not respect Hollow at all. So, I mean,
who said even Hollow even cares? If anyone,
I highly doubt he does anymore. I mean, I don't know what the hell has gotten into him. I mean, I guess it's that gold. And nonetheless, I mean, he did have to turn in a true Mayhem Championship for that opportunity, so it was a big gamble. Much like everyone else in the match, he now does not have a belt. Speaking of that, before the introductions get underway, Jerry Jeff, Seth Rollins later tonight in a grudge match inside the Cage of Death. That should be interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Introducing the challenger.
I will say, you know, this is the first time I've ever matched. I'm very curious to see how these two are going to work in the ring.
KSJ.
Wait for the introduction. KSJ, you got to give him the respect here. I mean, this is going to be a 5-star match. Come on, bro.
Introducing the champion from Richmond, Virginia, weighing in at 250 pounds. He is the Universal Wrestling Alliance United States Champion, the Outlaw L. Ken Howell.
And yeah, you hear the crowd reaction to Hollow. It's pretty mixed. It's like 50-50. Okay, what were you saying?
I'm just saying, like, this is going to be an interesting match. You know, Hollow has shown a ruthless side in the past, but he's not too much on the flair as KSJ is, where he'll go for, like, you know, flips and stuff like that.
I wouldn't necessarily say flips, but he's like really good at like transition wrestling, I guess is one way to put it. Like he's really mobile,
I mean,
in the ring. And speaking of that, jeez, and this is starting out hot here as Hollow counters, and now Hollow set KSJ up, man. I didn't expect a start quite like that. And now Hollow, right on the ropes. Man, that's that vicious side showing there, utilizing the ropes early on. KSJ, and the disrespect. Yeah, he definitely, Hollow does not care. I mean, it's pretty clear KSJ does not respect Hollow. Hollow does not respect KSJ either. And that's pretty brutal considering KSJ had such a great United States title reign here in the UWA. It's pretty iconic. I don't know if anyone will ever live up to it. But you got to assume that might be the goal of Hollow here, is to outlast KSJ's title reign as United States champion. And KSJ's got it, no air raid crash into the neck breaker.
I got to say, that knee rocked Hollow.
Yeah, no kidding, but I'd also say that the ropes have rocked KSJ. Both of them got hit with big moves early on here. This came out hot, but what do you expect when... I mean, like I said, you've got two people. KSJ feels though Hollow does not deserve the title. Hollow, I don't think he cares about anything, to be honest. Dropkick to the back there. I mean, your grandpa's put in the hospital. Why would you? Right there, leg trip into a roundhouse kick. So, I mean, you know, half the crowd understand that they're feeling for Hollow, but the other half are like, man, Nakamura, he was doing great in that tournament, and Hollow just steps in and just goes complete dickhead, and then he also cost KSJ his match against Chris Jericho on Shockwave.
I mean, I'm gonna point out, it's also how he won, like, the Pure Mayhem title, is it not? Coming in and at the fatal,
essentially,
triple threat. Yeah, he just came in and took the victory out of nowhere. You gotta keep your eye on this man. Whenever he's in the match, you need to keep your eyes focused on him, because he will come out of nowhere with a victory.
Nice kick up there earlier from Hollow, and now Hollow counters. Hollow showed a bit more athleticism this year. I mean, you got to keep that United States title. You've seen the amount of competition KSJ had to run through. Shinsuke Nakamura, Hammerstone, Brian Cage, Chris Jericho, just to name a few. Hollow's got him up. He was going for the Death Hollow driver. KSJ scouting it into the double knees to the chest. I mean, do you think Hollow has it in him to beat KSJ? I mean, he hasn't yet. And right now, KSJ's got him with a switch off.
Oh, damn.
This could be a short title reign here for Delson Hollow. Two-time champ KSJ. No, Hollow kicks out at two. That was close.
Very.
That happened out of nowhere, too. I mean, KSJ's right back at the speed. Hollow's going to watch that. Oh, man.
Right to the jaw with that knee.
And a head off the knee there. And now Hollow rallying back here. A couple forearms. Going to catch him with that swing blade. Some old school there from Delson Hollow. And now right into another running neck, swinging neck breaker there, rather. It's a nice move from Hollow. Yeah. Hollow lifts KSJ right back up to his feet. Going for the Hollow Valley driver again, but for the Death Hollow driver once again. KSJ able to scout it, Ben. And now, what the hell is... Oh man, that was an interesting Northern Lights arm trap suplex there.
People bringing stuff out of nowhere for this match.
And no kidding, now, oh, this is vintage KSJ with the submission. He used it on Cage back at Wrestleverse. This is the Beast Bite. Oh, but Hollow fighting out of it.
Oh, elbows right to the bridge of the nose, I believe.
Yeah, KSJ's caught him, though. KSJ caught him. Wait, not for long, though. Hollow with a clothesline. And these two are now a third neck breaker coming from Hollow. It connects with a third one right into the cover. One. One count. Man, this is very interesting so far here as Hollow lifts KSJ back up this feet. Here we go. Death Hollow driver right into the cover. One, two, and a two count. Very impactful move there. Hollow's going for the finish here.
We're about to see the most impactful move in his arsenal.
One in the chamber. One in the chamber connects to KSJ cover. Come on, ref, where you at, bro? One, two. KSJ kicks out. Now that is called one in the chamber. Does he have another in the chamber? That's going to be the big question here. Can he follow up, Ben? Can Hollow stay in control, man? No one kicks out of the one in the chamber. It's what he used to knock off Nakamura. It only took one at Wrestleverse. KSJ was able to stay alive, though. Hollow counter whips him into the corner. What the hell is Delson doing here? Oh, God. A hanging variation of the Sleepy Hollow here in the corner. Of course, he had to let go of it. His feet were on the ropes there. That would have been an illegal submission hold. Cover only a one count. See, Hollow's just, he's playing within the rule book here, but he's very, he's treading the line. Let's put it that way. Oh, God, now KSJ coming back here. Double knees to the stomach. And the second one, and now here we go, Ben. Hollow's in trouble. Benadryler connects. Right to the side of the head of Delson Hollow. That's vintage KSJ. And Hollow right now is grabbing his head. He's hurt, man. KSJ now calling him up for the finish. A second switch off, but Hollow blocks it. Sets him on the ropes here. What is this? Oh, God. We're out of the way, ref. Jesus!
Oh, fuck! Straight decapitation.
Holy hell, and right there, a counter from KSJ. KSJ's trying to stay in it, man, but he's on Dream Street right now. Holy shit, we've seen Hollow use the ropes earlier. Shoves off the cutter there to Delson. Oh my God, no, Jesus!
Sending him over the top.
Holy crap, he just sent him out to the floor there. Man, these two are not messing around here. KSJ's trying to get back in this, but he's hurt, bro. KSJ now has got Hollow right where he wants and kicks out his legs. Now KSJ's setting him up for something big here. A second Benadryler. A second Benadryler to the head of Delson Hollow.
Both these men look like they're going on empty.
And now KSJ's calling for the finish. A second switch off here. Switch off, wait. Hold that thought counter there by Hollow. And by Hollow's caught him. And one in the chamber times two. One, two, three. What a retain there.
Both these men fought with everything they have.
What a retain there for the United States title. I mean, KSJ had a great run. Hollow starting off really good here. That was a great match with KSJ. I don't know if he quite earned the respect of KSJ here, but I think he built towards it, at least. And I mean, at the end of the day, he retained his title, which is all he really cares about, I think. And nonetheless, right there, the Benadryller. What a bunch of highlights here from this match. This is definitely the best match in the pay-per-view. Foster match in the Universe Canon all over this year. Nice retain there for Hollow. I'll give it to him as cheap as he did it.